Warning. Adequate encryption has not been verified. Transmission interception is possible. Please confirm identity. I'm authorized only to speak with the Red Blade.
This is the Red Blade. You want to tell me what's going on?
Master Blade, I am to inform you that your loyal associate Jeek awaits you at the attached coordinates. Please proceed with all appropriate haste. Also, welcome back to Rishi after your long sojourn on Hata.
You're now 2 meters inside an Umbaran jamming field. If I've pressed the right buttons, we should have adequate privacy.
I received your message for the Red Blade.
Yes, perhaps a bit obvious, but I thought your pirate cover appropriate given the circumstances. So how is independence suiting you, Agent? No one to answer to or interfering with your decisions?
I'm working with Sith more than I expected. But the cause is right, and it's on my terms.
I'm glad to hear it.
How are you even alive?
As it turns out, there was concern that I had arranged for certain documents to be released in the event of my death. Instead of execution, I was granted early retirement.
Sounds very straightforward.
Very. I assure you, however, I am no longer involved. I've come only to ask you a personal favor.
Everything I have is at your disposal. No questions asked. Name the job.
Shara Jen, the former Keeper and Watcher 2.
Go on.
After the Star Cabal's disillusion, Shara was unwell. The damage to her brain from the Cabal's trap had been considerable.
I remember her medical droid. She had trouble speaking.
Add to that her conditioning. She was programmed for loyalty, and we had her working a rogue operation. That aggravated her existing cognitive and psychogenic trauma. She's fortunate she didn't become a vegetable. During Lord Malgus's uprising and the chaos that followed, she was unable to protect herself.
What happened?
She was captured by the Republic. I intend to free her.
I'm guessing we're not on Rishi to attack Belsavis prison. How do we get to her?
I've made arrangements already. She was carbonite frozen and placed aboard a prison transport, which was then raided by pirates.
And now the raiders have brought their cargo to Rishi?
Precisely. The final step is to retrieve the body and erase all evidence. No one can know what happened. I intend to negotiate Shara's purchase from the raiders. While I do, I need you to provide leverage and cover our trail.
It won't be a problem. What kind of leverage am I providing?
To begin with, I suggest you slice the raiders' databanks and transmit their files to me. That should facilitate negotiations.
I'm sure they've made indiscretions we can use. And after that?
You'll have the frequency to listen in. You know how this works. You'll find what I need. We can rendezvous here once I've acquired the carbonite.
All right. Let's bring Shara home.
Good to be here. The meeting now. Keep moving, don't get caught, and delete all records of the raid on the prison transport. Any files that might provide leverage, send to me.
Understood.
Ah, you must be Trade Master Kavork of the Red Media Consortium.
Yes. And you are the human who wishes to trade.
I understand. You acquired items from the prison transport recently. I'd like to buy the lot.
Why you want frozen prisoners?
Republic carbonite freezing units are superior to my clients. Keep the prisoners, I only want the boxes.
Do we look like jailers?
Then we'll dump the bodies ourselves. Just don't expect us to pay extra.
Maybe we sell it all back to the Republic.
Oh, I'm sure I can find it.
I'm done, dude. Sending now.
Why should we not sell to the Republic?
For one thing, I have files right here showing you destroyed a Republic transport last year.
What?
Video evidence from your own ship.
How you get this?
It fell into my hands. I'm sure there's more where that came from.
Uploading files now.
I see you've also had financial difficulties.
You lie!
Oh, I don't believe so. You've racked up quite a debt to some Trandoshan pirates. Does your crew know you've been gambling?
Maybe I'll make sure you don't tell.
Well, maybe I can do you a favor. By the time we're finished here, your creditors will be gone.
Not possible. Maybe I prefer you gone.
Go ahead. Call the man you owe a debt to. See if he answers.
Marus! Marus!
He's gone. Now, imagine. If my people can do that to your enemies over the course of this conversation, what do you suppose they can do to you?
All right. We sell carbonite prisoners.
It's been a pleasure doing business.
How are you feeling?
I've been thawed from carbonite, paced by 25 meagles, and injected with something I can only describe as liquid humiliation.
I'm pleased you're doing well.
I'm right. Did you tell me? I can see stars. Am I on a spaceship?
Yes, you are. You're safe and you're going to be better soon.
Don't condescend to me.
My apologies. If you'll excuse me. Hold transmission, silence audio.
You said we'd all meet back here.
Yes, I lied. She's on her way to a private medical facility. I couldn't be sure you'd approve.
After everything we've been through, you'd still rather manipulate me than trust my judgment.
It's nothing personal. My wife has the same complaint.
Where is she going?
Shara will be cared for in secret by a group of richly compensated medics and scientists. In a very slow and regrettably painful process, the damage to her brain will be repaired and her loyalty programming undone.
You can do that?
There are no guarantees. My people say it should be possible. When she is free, I have advised her not to rejoin the Empire's service and to make a life away from conflict. She's never had that chance before.
After we defeated the Star Cabal, I could have escaped too. You advised me to keep working for the good of the Empire.
You signed up to join Imperial Intelligence. You kept fighting after everything that happened. You made choices to continue on your terms. She never did. I'm giving her that chance. Talk to her if you like. Say your goodbyes.
Shara, do you recognize me?
Are you concerned about hibernation blindness or the brain damage? Of course I recognize you. The minister, former minister, says you helped me. I don't want to do this, Cypher. I don't want them to decondition me.
You don't have to be scared. You're not a prisoner. Say the word and I'll talk to the minister.
I do have to be scared. The Empire altered my limbic system. I'm sorry I haven't been there for you, Cypher. Everything else just got in the way, and I'm all right, I am. I just don't know who I'll be without.
You're the smartest person I've ever met, and you're very good at solving mysteries. I have every confidence you'll figure it out.
Maybe, but I hate mysteries. I'm glad you're here. Stay and talk for a little while.
I believe our business is done. I have a retirement to get back to, and while I don't expect we'll meet again, I believe I've said that before.
You've more than earned the rest. It's been a pleasure working together one last time.
With you as well, Agent. There is one other thing, by the way. I may be out of the game, but you're not. I hear rumors intelligence is on the verge of reforming at last. Darth Maar wants you to advise and oversee. Independent, but with full access.
Darth Maar considers my independence to be treason.
Yes, but you'd be a check against any Sith who'd use intelligence for their own schemes. A new agency will need new personnel to replace those lost. I have files with potential recruits. Untraditional, but highly skilled.
What kind of untraditional recruits?
Military deserters, terrorist sympathizers, and Malgus's alien insurgents. All of them believers in a better empire.
If we're going to survive, we need everyone who believes in any empire, working together. I'll make sure these recruits are put to good use.
If I understand the coming threats, you'll need them. But as I said, I'm out of the game, and the files are yours. Watch for enemies within and without. Everything is on you now, and you know the stakes for civilization.